Once I was injured, I never thought I'd be able to do any activity again whatsoever. And to discover that I can do climbing, or especially ice climbing, I was super excited, yet super nervous.
I've always loved rock climbing because, you know, other sports with other people, you kind of interact with them and they might have opinions of you based on having a disability. But when you're out in the rock or the ice, the rock and the ice, it doesn't care that you have a disability. It's not going to change for you or treat you different.
And someone said, just come out, just give it a try. And I was very apprehensive, but I figured, why the hell not? Just let's go and do it. And then that very first time, I got hooked, and I've been climbing ever since.
We have one participant on our trip this year who really expressed a lot of hesitation.
I talked to the director and said, I don't really know if I want to participate or even show up tomorrow.
And then as soon as she started climbing, I mean, her eyes lit up and she just kept expressing how amazing it was.
You know, when I have somebody who thought that it would be the most horrifying experience ever, smiling and laughing 40 feet off the ground, there's nothing that beats that.
Oh my God, I had no idea what to expect at all. Like, I didn't know what crampons were. Cool. I'd never seen an ice pick. I'm like, I don't know what I'm doing.
I think it's very interesting that ice climbing is kind of an adaptive sport for everybody. Everybody's wearing crampons, everybody's using ice axes, everybody's adapting in a certain way, so it's very natural for us.
And we're all different. That's what's crazy too, is that each of us have, you know, other, like some kind of need that we have to adapt to.
Get that left foot in there.
He's fine, no, yeah.
Yeah, your life does not have to end with limb loss or loss of sight. There's so much that life has to offer, and we just have to seize the opportunity.
You're here to climb? Okay, cool, that's a good climb.
So for me, the big thing with climbing has a lot to do with my mental health. I have complex PTSD and a dissociative disorder. With ice climbing, I found like the cold of the ice against my face and my body. It just keeps me in the present moment, so I'm not like dissociating all the time.
It's worth being cold to experience being on ice. It's not like any other climbing I've ever done.
I have to say, it was so different than rock climbing. You swing those pickaxes for a little bit and you get your crampons in, and after a while you're going, shoot, I am tired and I'm only halfway up.
So climbing without one hand isn't as hard as it seems. I mean, there's certainly hard parts, but since I was born without my hand, it's the only kind of climbing I know.
This year I started using a climbing foot for the first time, which has been pretty fun to kind of figure out how to use that, and it's been working real well.
And it doesn't make a difference if you make it to the top. It's just about overcoming your personal goal that you have set for yourself. And as long as you do that, then you're winning.
I've been in search for like a family out here since I moved out here, and Paradox has become my family.
It really gets me how much they all love each other. No matter what their disability is, no matter what their challenge is, they're always there for you. And it doesn't matter if I met them today or if I've known them for 5 years, they're all there for you.
Getting out in nature gives you the beauty and the feeling that you're part of this world and not just disabled.
Oh gosh, just the things I've accomplished the last 2 days, I never thought I'd be able to accomplish in my lifetime. I actually succeeded and made it all the way to the top.
I started climbing with Paradox Sports in 2007, and just through that progression and mentorship, on May 23rd, 2016, I summited Mount Everest.
Every day is a gift, and you gotta live your own adventure. You know, we're not given, we're not promised tomorrow, so, you know, do something every day that's crazy and that gives you joy, because that's all you have, is today. And if you're doing what you love, then That's all you need.